we are. Why are lonesome? So I guess we will. Hello, hello, welcome to Terrain Tuesday. For those that are here so far, I'm gonna kind of wait who shows up before we get too started on stuff. I will be right back. I forgot something that I need for today. Hang in there. All right. I am back. Hello, hello, hello. Hi from Ron and Teresa. Hello, Ron and Teresa. How are you tonight? Kimberly, how are you doing tonight? Hopefully everybody can hear me okay. More junk. You're ready? Still getting over a cold. I know the feeling well. I have been getting over when the weather starts getting cold, throws my sinuses into a fit. And I had to deal with that all last week and through the weekend, but it seems to be sorting itself out finally. I'm sure as I've gone around, sniffling and everybody. I probably scared to death everybody that they're getting ready to die from COVID. Hopefully not, but you never know. Folks. Good. I'm glad to hear that. I had James up over the weekend. I'm good. Like I said, I had James up over the weekend and we kind of made a bro weekend out of it and kind of painted on some things and and worked on a couple of projects. So we're gonna mess with those a little bit more tonight. And then I continue to get questions about how to set up infantry. So we are going to build an infantry squad, or two or three, as the case may be, or get started on them anyway. So we'll get started with that tonight. And we're working on more desert terrain. If you follow us on Facebook or anything, you'll know that I finally got the skeletal creature done. I don't want to call it a dragon. I guess you can call it a dragon. So it's all right for Star Wars. They call theirs a crate dragon. Thank you. Yeah, we kind of moved some stuff around so we'd have an area to paint and goof off with. This time in spring is the best time to work out in the shop because we don't have real air conditioning or heating out there. So when the weather's nice, it's good. We got plenty of room to stretch out there and work on stuff, not be as uncomfortable, especially during the winter. The cold doesn't bother me. James seems to be like the cold might be a little more bothersome to him. Yep, he is a kind soul, sure. But we had a good time. Hopefully he'll be up again soon and we'll do it again and we'll get all this COVID stuff behind us and we can start branching out and going places again and doing stuff with people. All right, so Mr. Dragon is... Skeleton bones is done for the moment. He's got some spots. I made sure when I put him together that he's got some spots where a calf can sit, do some stuff. They want to climb up on the hill there a little bit, shoot over him. So I look forward to using these pieces in a game. So. Yeah, most people are not cold weather people. I am a cold weather person. I hate hot weather, but I hate. So, all right. So some of the pieces that I've got here, I need to add some more rock and gravel to it so I can finish painting them and adding to them. They need a little more texture to them after we put the sand on them. Pretty much got all the base colors on them that I've done. Like I did after I got the dragon, the skeleton attached to the other piece. I went back in with an airbrush with some thinned down varnish and sprayed it in spots. So I'll go back and do that too. But right now I need to add some rocks. So I'm going to get my trusty duty cup of rocks and my cup of gravel. And we're going to build some areas on here. See what we can come up with. Handy dandy glue out. So I'm going to put some rocks out first. We're going to add some rocks. Now, these are just rocks that I pick up out of the driveway side and give them a nice water bath. Let them dry. Good to go. That. And however you do it, just do it. You know, you go outside, you see how it is. There's no rhyme or reason to rocks and boulders and how they're set up. So, reason to be super worried about doing it right, doing it wrong, all works. But if these are all kind of top pieces, so I want to have, you know, I want to have a little more zip to them, I guess. You know, I just kind of look at the rocks and, hey, that'd be a cool rock. Add to it. And they make it, there's a lot of little rock bits. You can get his finger. There's always somebody out there willing to take your money. I just choose to use rocks out of my way because they're free. Relatively. Don't be worried about crazy with glue. You want to have on there, putting in the. You'll never even see your eyes and you. Got in my couple of rocks. All right, so that ought to get some big rocks on there. Handy dandy cup here. Oh, sorry, get some of the little. Little tiny one. To the. Got in here. Get us those up here. All right, so for this, what I like to do is, let's see. Just kind of take some glue again and kind of look around with my rocks where they're at and kind of where I want some gravel to go around them so that they fit now. And this is where my gravel comes. Couple of these little ones in here. Okay, now I'm going to put a little gravel here. All my glue covered. Okay, got that one on there. You say this is all extremely messy. Sure, you do it somewhere you can clean up. All right. So let's see. We got a paper plate. Maximum gravel. Yeah, gravel is always good. So I look at this, I'm kind of like, I'll look and see where I want gravel to be. I'm kind of happy with that. I don't like how that looks. What I'm going to do is this is where I use my spray. So this is a mix of about 50% Elmer's glue and water. So I'm going to go ahead and I want to soak these real good. I'm not worried about getting on my stuff. I've already painted stuff all dry. Pretty clear. And put some paint. We want to soak this real good. Then I can always come in here and junk brushes and clean off some of the glue here so that there shouldn't really. I said, I don't worry about it too much. By the time we come back in, do and spray some mat over it to seal it up when it's all done, it'll all be good. Anyway, so that kind of gets that on there. And you say, now it's got to give it plenty of time to dry. I usually let it go overnight. But that kind of see, it's kind of already set up there. So I'm going to set that to the side. Oh, I'm going to come back in here and do it again. All right, so let's see here. This one. All right, put some more glue down to kind of give it a base. Okay, so we're going to use some of our gravel from earlier. A little bigger piece. So, all right, I'm going to sprinkle them a little on. I'm going to try to control a little time because I've got this spot. Now, what I use for my gravel, this is like just dry all. you can get like at O'Reilly's. Some people use kitty litter. I like to use it. This is some kind of, I really like it because it really soaks up the water. Shaking that around a little bit to get. All right, then we go back in here and peel it, soak it up again. Normally I would have done this when I was building it. Wasn't 100% sure how. And right. All right. Yes. Okay, that piece done. All right, now we've got this one. Kind of make. In here. All right. Possible. Right. Yeah. Careful or look off. Yeah, all right. That piece done. Fast. All right. Now, big piece. Sure. It's more just kind of idea of where I'm trying to get to. A little gravel in here. Like I said, it's just kind of like even like a gravel fall, like you see. You want it? Be good to go. All right. I'm here. Cavalry. Here. Everybody's awfully quiet tonight. Are you enthralled? All right, that gets me that piece. All right, so that gets all of our top heel pieces. Stuff on them. Now comes the fun of cleaning up my mess. I tend to just throw all this all away so that it's got glue mixed in it or something. I don't have to worry about it all. Turn it into a great big pot. All right. That will go to cast off. Okay, so now I have these pieces here. These are going to be kind of like my rough pieces that I want too. So I've already graveled these. But now these need sand. So what we're gonna do here is. Okay, so we're going to use this dirty plate. So for this, what I want to do here, since I've already got this down, and obviously it's painted at all, so that is, we're going to go ahead and we're going to give it a good dose of glue water. Try not to get much on. Apparently. All right, so then got my bucket of sand here. Take this, which are a sink. And I want to sprinkle some sand, especially around my really trying to get into the gravel that much. And I'm kind of going at this backwards because I ended it first. Texture. Then I'm going to go over it again with another spray, spritz. Make sure that the sand is good and soaked in there. Put that off. Bottom. All right, piece number two here. Let's try this. Do the some sand. And this is just playground sand that I picked up at the hardware store. I take it through like a flower sieve so that I get more of the finer sand rather than gravels or rocks or something. This is just more for sure. And here after the end of the show, I'll move all these to a better drying area. Come in tomorrow and find it stuck to me. Blue on here again. Shake off this there. All right. All right. So this is always so messy. So much better to have a bigger spot to work in. But for the sake of what we're doing here, we got to make it work. All right. We're going to water here. Up our overspray. Here we go. Now we're rocking. Paper towels everywhere. We have enough. What I've got here is I basically cut a piece of 3/4 inch maple, kind of like your finish plywood for building cabinets and stuff. Kind of cut it out to the shape I wanted it here to fit on top of it, like a folding table. And then sealed it with varnish real good. Wipe paint off of it if I spill or something. Okay. So what we're going to work on now, as I mentioned earlier, is infantry. All that other stuff's got to dry. Every week I get more questions about how to set up infantry. How do I do infantry? So that's what we're going to work on today. We're going to do Terrans, which they are, and that's where one of the things, when you're looking at the faction doctrines, what you're worried about are the squads. The individual models, on the Terrans, I think they show like 8 guys, 10 guys to a model. Let's see. They have got changed in some strata. So pulling that up. Sure, I'm telling you. Thing. All right, so Terran Federation Infantry, a model which is a Hastati for light and heavy infantry is what we're building here. It has 8 figures to a model. It has 6 legionnaires, a senior legionnaire, and a centurion. Now the squad has 5 models, 5 Hastatis. So needless to say, I don't want to put 8 guys to a base. It's just a waste. You don't need that many. They're not going to fit on the bases that come with it. Then you're going to have to make bigger ones. And it's up to you. I mean, if you want to make a bigger base and be more accurate, you can. But it's not necessary. So what I've done first is I have opened up some heavy infantry, some of our new hammer infantry. And I have primered them all. And then I have split them into groups of 4 and glued them to popsicles. Here for me to use. So the regular infantry that come in heavy has 2 rifle guys, submachine guy, and an officer NCO. So I've glued those so that they're all the same. So I've got, these are all rifle guys here. That's a submachine gun. So basically, I've got 4 popsicle sticks of rifle guys, 16 guys. I've got 8 officers and NCOs, and then I have 8 submachine guns. So what I normally do when I'm building squads, I set them up so that I have them by use, so that I know where they're going. So I make rifle squads, I make SMG squads, and etc. Now, I started painting some last And here's the other thing. This is the reason why these things are so small. You know, if you really, you're young and really want to go crazy and do all that. Me, I can't hardly see. So I just kind of touch out some of the, you know, some of the armor, some of the helmet and stuff like that. And so what I do is I just take my popsicle stick and normal glue. Because what I've got over here on my plate is I've got some, these are heavy weapons and light mortars. So I'm going to, same thing, I'm going to come in here and I'm going to maybe. All the fun with glue. Got to dry up. I feel like I'm the pimple pop. Digging for the core. Out the other. Usually I can just grab it and it'll kind of come out one. All right. Hey, glue's clear out. Okay, so I just put a little drop here, little drop. It's gonna be one of those nights. Okay, again. Okay. I try to spread them out about an inch apart. I mean, you can use bigger sticks. Like this way, because it's easier to get to. Yeah, there's some color. All right, so I'm gonna look over here. I got with the heavy weapons, I get more officers. Grab the. Probably won't get to it tonight, but after we get these set up and get them ready to base, then we'll be able to show how we start. All right, so there was a couple officers. Let's see. Got some heavy machine gunners. Guys on. Then we've got Stinger guys. Then we've got Laser guys. These are all coming off the heavy weapon sprue. You get a machine gunner, a laser, a Panzerfaust. And officers. Right. You notice I've got my I voted sticker. I hope everybody voted today. All right. Now our Panzerfaust. Officer. That's okay. It all counts. You get a sticker for own personal use. Make your own. Okay. Then we've got. Let's see, we have our order guys, and then we have like our controllers. These are with their little data pads. That's going to leave me six mortar guys. I'm going to put three and three. Camera here. But before we can get them all ready to base, these are drying. Because what happens is I put these all on the sticks here, and then I'm going to let them dry. And after they dry, I go back with my black paint and up any little nicks or spots that I might have missed. Moving them around. Since our infantry metal times are chip a part off of. Alright, so got all these guys. So what I basically am doing with these is I go in and I touch their armor up with a little gray, leave the black inside the crevices and everything. Put a little yellow for their faceplate. Red on their shoulders and their gauntlets and the hawk on the top there. That's all I do to them. That's all I'm going to keep. Here. So this is dirty gray, a Reaper paint. That all nice and shaken up. Shaken, not stirred. All right, so I'm gonna get a little gray here. I use a pretty small brush to do this with. Say 18-aught. Very, very small. And I just go in here now and pick out where I'm going to put my gray. And just kind of trying to get a little bit of a highlight while I'm out. you have a hard time trying to figure out what's what, you can always paint a few of them white, do a little black wash on them, see a little bit. But like I said, all I'm trying to do is just jump on. I like. I'm sure there's people out there that want to try to paint these. I just work my way around. I do the backs, the sides, and the front. Do the helmets last. Fancy dry brushing, no brushes, stuff. I guess you could try painting them gray, primer them gray, or worry about. It'll be close enough. So, and then after I get them all painted, go ahead and finish the bases up with grass. It on his lower torso. ever fails. Little spot I'm in. Luckily, I'm a patient man. You must have much patience to, especially piles of. Now, when it comes to factions, I don't paint. So I kind of just same infantry or some. You know, you can do that. You can paint them up in kind of a matching color or something. Totally a reason I kind of go with the gray. No matter who I'm playing. All right, so that gets their bottom parts. Now I go ahead and their upper arm. In fact, I do all this first and do the weapons last. Up a little. All right, now the sides of their helmets. Kind of a little ridge and then back area and then it's. Gotcha. not one or. That's how I do them. Pay attention to. All right. Spraying on me. All right, so we'll let my hands heal for a second. Plate up. For no more paint that I'm using. Got one. All right. I grab another one and do it again. Old song. Clean my butt once in a while to. Right. Got a wet palette. Paint from. We're in our second hour. Guys, feel free to ask questions. You don't even have to be. I'm working. Ask a random question. Give you a random. So are you planning pink infantry? Do we see some pink infantry in the future? Infantry get kind of a bum rap sometimes, that you've got to be careful with them because they, if you get too much of them in the game, it just slows. There's any of them. Cool thing about infantry is they're cheap. Well, I wasn't sure which one was typing, so What color would you do yours, Ron? Like here in this, in the case of this squad, there's going to be five models, five bases. Each base takes 3 points of damage to kill. So, you know, you basically have a 15 DT model, whole squad of infantry. Like an all rifle squad, you know, would cost you like 100. And the nice thing about infantry is, for the most part, you can only do 1 point of damage to an attack. So you can have a guy show up and unload all of his guns on him, but because they depend, olive, drab, and purple. I use that a lot with very much. There's no set rule, other than odd building mechanics that get in the way. You just kind of have to, take into account that lots and lots of everyone. So don't want to go crazy with it. But they're a fun thing to have, especially in city fights and so forth. Have to use them in moderation when you're. That's the main reason we don't generally allow infantry in tournaments, because of the fact that somebody could lose strictly because you borrowed something. Hello, Tiger Wraith. How are you tonight? Not as worried about getting it on. That for all my little machine gun guys. Time for some fresh paint here. Start on our officer. And the same thing again. The other thing, officer, they don't have show. Flash call. Kind of use kind of a now, the other thing that I do too is figure officer. What I like to do is, for my NCOs, I just pose. Officers, I generally paint their one of their shoulder pads. Have like senator. Early. truer. Guys are a lot. You keep cutting in and out. Well, that's because I keep turning down. I'm sorry. I meant to mount me a new one down lower. Let's see here. Turn it a little bit. Maybe that'll pick it up a little better. Not a matter of whether it's a wireless or not a wire, it's just it's mounted above me. It didn't, no matter what. No, it's because if I'm looking up, I'm talking into the mic. When I've got my head down, when I'm painting and talking, it's not. And I need to mount it. But I hate to have it right in front of my face. I will try to do better. I've got some lapel mics. I've got some lapel mics I need to hook up, go back to. We set this one up back when we were doing CAVCon so that both me and James could talk. I just keep getting to go back and set it back up. All right, so now we just need to do their helmets. Gray. All right, that finishes one officer's hand. Only 10 million more to go. Now I remember why I haven't done infantry for a long time. ever so slowly we go. Need to do the helmets. Now that these ones that I glued earlier have dried a little bit, break it up a little bit, I go in with a little black now and make sure I touch up any spots that didn't get totally primered. Time to get a little speckled. So we're starting all with black. Give them a good once over. As well as you would like. I got that. Showing. Got enough on it that the paint is thick. Silver coming out. All righty. Now we're getting about to the finish point tonight. So what I will continue to do during the week, get all these little guys finished up. And then next week, start building infantry stuff. You know, I base them and how I figure out what goes on to a base. How I set them up for the different heavy weapon guys or guys or what. And hopefully we will have bunches of these guys ready to go. Hard to see. We'll get them all done. These guys just... Okay, so that gets our gray down. All right, then just I'll finish up a guy here with the a little submachine gun guys. So now we want to put on the red. And this is on their rest of their helmet, their shoulder pads, and then their gloves. Red can be a little tricky going on black, so sometimes you have to kind of... put one on and let it dry or get it thick. And again, I'm just trying to just kind of get it a little on the top. I'm not worried about covering every little nook and cranny. Let the black be the shadow there. got missed. That sometimes you might have to hit the red a couple of times. All right, I'm going to hit their crest here on their helmet. Got to get the top and then back and do the back. Just try to fix any spots that I can without getting too crazy with it. All right, so now I got the red on there. I want to do their faceplate. And I think I used a safety yellow for those earlier. This is probably the trickiest part of all of them. It's hard to get in there and try to get a little paint on. Little square. Like so. And I've got a little gunmetal silver here. and I paint all their weapons. Try again. Oh, I have a bunch of holes. Got it. We will cheat, pop off. All right, so we're just going to kind of grab and over here and do their guns. I almost kind of do all just a little bit of dry brush. That way keeps a little bit of the black in there, maybe. A little bit. Kind of in between a painting and a dry brush. Try to leave the end of the barrel black. Okay, that's all I do to my infantry. So basically four colors and like I said, I think it makes for a good little easy paint job on them. And especially when you're doing lots of them. That it looks how close you can look on them, but it puts enough paint on them that I think, you know, especially at this scale, when they're on the board and they've got nice basing around them, I think they turn out pretty good. So, like I said, this week I will get more of these painted up so that we can start basing next week. I did. Yeah, I just prime them on the sprues first. Then I clip them off. And then I sand the bottoms back so they're nice and flat with metal. I use a little grinder, but you can use sandpaper or file or whatever. and then glue them onto the popsicle sticks with a little Elmer's glue so that they're a little easier to get to move around. After the glue sets, I go back with black and make sure I fill in any of the holes. And then from that point, I just touch the armor up with gray, do some red for highlights, do a little yellow for the faceplate, and a little silver for the weapons. Now, it, like I said, you can paint them black, do a little zenithal priming with a little white, if you're going to use a lighter color or something that you pop out. I like to do them base black, that way I don't have to cover everything shadow. But you could primer them white, you could wash them with black. That would probably make the detail pop out a little bit more if you're trying to see, or you could dry brush them after you primer them black. You can dry brush them with a light color or something like that. There's dozens of ways of doing it. It's just what you think looks good. I just have always painted right onto the black primer and just left the black as shadow. But, like I said, when right here I've got, 9, 12, 15, 27, 30, 42, about 54 figures. And having to paint all those little guys will drive you crazy. But when it's all done, I'll have, out of 54 guys, I'll have almost 20 bases. Since we're doing Terran, that's almost 4 squads of Terran. And they'll be set up for rifle squads, SMG squads, all my heavy weapons, light mortar. So I generally put 3 guys to a base. Like here, what I do is, I've got 2 rifle guys here and an NCO. So, I'll put the NCO on front. Like so, and then I'll go in after they're glued, fill in and do the facing on them. But right there, that is a rifle model. Part of, I need 5 of those for a squad for all rifles. So it's an easy and quick. If you want to put more guys on there, you can. If you want to put less guys, you just put 1 guy on there if you want to. You don't have to specialize them if you don't want to. I do just because I have a lot more access to them, but I just think it makes for a better behind the story, if it says these guys are rifle or whatever. But like I said, I'll get all these painted this week, and then we'll be ready to start basing. So anybody have any more questions before I call it a night? Don't forget, me and James will be back tomorrow at 8 o'clock Central Time for our CAV HQ Live talk about. I think we are planning on talking about how to use the construction program and the force manager program. Kind of give some examples of how I build models and stuff. So we'll have that for tomorrow night. Then Saturday, Chris will be back at 2 o'clock Central Time, working on Saturday sculpting. He's finishing up the Akula right now, which is a hover craft for Amethril. So you can check here below and see the video from last week. He got almost done with it. So I would imagine he'll be done with it and start on something new. So other than that, I'm going to call it a night. If nobody has any questions, speak now or forever hold your peace. Bueller. Well, guys and girls, thanks for joining us tonight. It was a good show. I know it's like watching grass grow or paint dry, paint infantry, but what it is. So, anyway, I hope to see you tomorrow night, 8 o'clock Central Time. Me and James will be on for an hour. We'll see you later.